Well, the trouble with our liberal friends is not that they're ignorant. It's just that they know so much that isn't so.
The following has been rated PC for politically correct.
Pay attention, you just may learn something.
It's the Sage, Larry Elder.
Let's turn to the 14th Amendment. Here is what President Trump said.
On immigration, some legal scholars believe you can get rid of birthright citizenship without changing the Constitution.
With an executive order.
Exactly.
Right.
Have you thought about that?
Yes. It was always told to me that you needed a constitutional amendment.
Right. 14th Amendment.
You don't. Number one, you don't need that. Number two,
I mean, that's in dispute.
You could definitely
that's very much in dispute.
Well, you can definitely do it with an act of Congress, but now they're saying I can do it just with an executive order. Now, how ridiculous. We're the only country in the world where a person comes in, has a baby, and the baby is essentially a citizen of the United States for 85 years with all of those benefits. It's ridiculous. It's ridiculous. And it has to end.
Have you talked about that with counsel?
Yeah, I have.
So where in the process?
It's in the process. It'll happen. With an executive order. That's what you're talking about, right?
Yeah,
that's
exactly
very interesting.
What I'm about.
I didn't think anybody knew that but me. I thought I was the only one.
Professor Eastman, can he do this with an executive order?
Well, I believe he could. Let's just be real clear. First principles, the president cannot amend the Constitution by an executive order. Congress can't amend the Constitution by an act of Congress, and the Supreme Court isn't supposed to be able to amend the Constitution by issuing a judgment or a ruling in a case. But that's not what the president is talking about here. The Constitution doesn't require birthright citizenship. It says anybody born here and subject to the jurisdiction are citizens. All he's trying to do is clarify what that phrase subject to the jurisdiction means. And it doesn't mean anybody who happens to be subject to our laws because they're physically present here. It meant something much more complete than that, owing allegiance to the country, being part of the body politic. And that's what the debates on the 14th Amendment make clear. That's what the early Supreme Court decisions on this make clear. And the Supreme Court has never held otherwise. So that would mean that the children of citizens or the children of lawful permanent residents are automatically citizens by virtue of the 14th Amendment. But the children of temporary visitors, whether it's a tourist visa or a student visa, or certainly the children of people who are not lawfully present in the United States at all, are not automatic citizens according to the Constitution. And the president is just trying to faithfully apply that clause as it was drafted and ratified and as it meant to the people that passed it.
45 seconds left, Professor. I thought there was some sort of Supreme Court case that came out in the early 80s, had some sort of footnote which people point to argue that anybody who's in the country, even illegally, has a child on the American soil, is an automatic citizen. Isn't there some sort of case that people point to that rightly or wrongly they use to make that argument?
They do. It's a case called Plyler versus Dole, and it's the ridiculous case that said that states have to provide free education to the children of illegal immigrants under the Equal Protection Clause. And it cited a footnote that says, look, they're also citizens if they're born here. But that was not a holding of the case. It was not an issue in the case. It was just what we call dicta, that the Supreme Court just with the back of the hand added something.
Professor, got to run. Thank you very much for that. I really appreciate it.
All right. Take care, Larry.